All right, thank you. Nice to meet you all. Yeah, I'm Akira. I'm from Chiba University, Japan. Today, I want to talk about efficient forest monitoring using GEE, iTree, and 360 camera, CETA. And I want to talk about the urban forest and local forest. You know, that you have to, when you work in the developing countries, that's fine, but, you know, like you need to care about local forests too. You know, trees has many like ecological values there, but it's hard to monitor because, for example, when you take a look at the two-dimensional photos, grassland and forest are same green, no difference. And it means same value, you know, ecological value. If you don't distinguish between them, it means same value for it. What we need to do is we need to measure the vertical direction. So we need the 3D. And how we get the 3D data? And initially we focus on the airborne laser. Airborne laser is fine, but it's very expensive. And for example, Tokyo, the most of the forested area on the left is missing. You know, most of the densely populated area, airborne laser, they take it. And we started from, you know, terrestrial laser. Okay, terrestrial laser is fine, but, you know, coverage is limited. And we started to use, like, you know, drone. But drone is prohibited over the, you know, the city, like Tokyo. It's like prohibited. So what we find out, maybe we can, you know, we can use citizen scientists to collect more data. So, like, you know, vertical direction means, like, you know, within the canopy, what's kind of like a structure there? If there's more structures, means more biodiversity. So like, you know, we started to collect the CETA, like 360 camera CETA, and we created some fancy website, started to collect it. And we are waiting for the response. And finally, 5 posts in a few weeks, you know, months, only 5 posts. 1 post from me, 1 post from my colleague, and 3 posts from my student. Only 5 posts. Oh my God, you know. Like, oh my God. We are so disappointed. Like, you know, colleagues, student, me. We are all disappointed. And this is a solution. So now what we are doing right now is we ask the local park rangers to carry around the CETA to take the many, many trees, many, many forests. And that way, like, you know, tagged with the GPS, so we can see, like, what's the forest condition there. And also, we kind of like, we collected more data from recreational outdoor photos, like some of the sites, like many pictures going to the hiking and take some many pictures in the forest, and they upload it on for their fun. And we started to use such photos to see what's the forest condition there. So kind of like the bad thing about it is some of the photos, only the sign, some of the sign, no forest. And some of the photos, you know, there is a photos, but, you know, there is a forest. But, you know, this is like a winter image, not the summer image. So kind of we have to classify all data based on the season, based on the forest, or we are now classifying the data right now. But this is a kind of a good solution. When you don't need to wait for the photos, like collecting from the citizen scientist, more like, you know, encouragement is very important. So like people are encouraged to take a photo and post it on the website. We can use such resources to see what's the forest condition there. That is a perfect case for it. Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much.